What does quick mask do, and what's a stencil in Photoshop? A stencil in Photoshop is shown to you by marching ants. So we're going to get a new file here. Call it quick mask and stencil. Oops, stencil. We're going to make it 640 by 480. Doesn't need to be really large. 72 resolution. I'm going to change the background from white to transparent. Click OK. So when it's transparent, you see the checkerboard. I'm going to go up here and make a rectangle with the marquee tool. It's the second from the top in the toolbar. To show you how the stencil works, I have some blue in the foreground color. I'm going to get a brush. I have a hard brush at 10. And I can squiggle all over the place, but it's only going to paint within the borders of the marching ants. Marching ants are what create a stencil, what Photoshop recognizes as a stencil. Quick mask, which seems to be misunderstood, only edits the shape of marching ants. To do anything else besides edit that shape, you have to get out of quick mask back into marching ants. So I'm going to go up here and deselect, turn off the eyeball, make a new layer. I'm going to go here and make another rectangle. And let's say I want freehand corners. Well, I can't get freehand corners using add to or take away from a selection. For example, I've got the rectangle, and if I hold shift, I'll add to the corner. That's the manual way. You can also use these icons up here. If you hover over them, they'll tell you what they are. Intersect, subtract, add, and the new selection. I'm using the manual way. I'm going to hold the Option key on the Mac, the Alt key on the PC, and this subtracts from a selection. So I could use the polygon lasso and hold the Shift key. So I'm going to add a polygon. I'm going to hold the Option key or Alt key on the PC. I'm going to take away polygon. So that's adding to and taking away from selection. We'll just get a paintbrush here. We'll get a different color by clicking the foreground color. Got green. Maybe make a bigger brush with the right-hand bracket, which is the shortcut. Boom, boom, boom. See the shape? It's the shape we made. And I could fill in the whole thing, for that matter. But it protects everything outside this shape. I'm going to go Select, Deselect, or Command D, Control D on the PC. Turn off the eyeball so we don't have to look at it. We're on this layer 3. I really think it's a good idea to name layers, but we'll worry about that later. I'm going to go into this again to give myself, you don't have to have a base of marching ants to use quick mask, but I'm just going to show you this with a base. There we have it. And we're going to go, here's quick mask. It's under these two chips. I'm going to hit this little icon here. It would be the D key is the shortcut to get the default colors, black and white. And this little arrow, curvy arrow, X key is the shortcut, switches back and forth. I think as a beginner, you should always stick to black and white when you're working with masking. This is quick mask. Notice, well, it's green right now because I changed it. But it does default to kind of an orange color. If I double click, this is the color of the mask. This is the opacity of what you see. It's not the opacity of the mask. If the mask was thin, painted with gray, it would be make a transparency. We're not going to deal with that. That gets more advanced. But there's sort of an orange color that this defaults to. See that orange color? I'm going to turn it back into that, click OK. That's approximately the color that quick mask defaults to. So I'm going to get out of Quick Mask. We haven't done anything yet. There's Quick Mask. I'm going to get the brush. If I paint with white, that's what the shape is going to look like when we get out of Quick Mask. If I paint with black, I'm going to hit the X key. I'm going to put a black X in here. Get out of Quick Mask. That's the shape of the stencil. I'm going to get a color, pink, magenta, and paint. And you see, anything outside the marching ants is protected. So maybe I'll get another color, get some blue. And that's pretty much Quick Mask edits an existing mask shape. Or I'm going to go to deselect, select, deselect. And I'm going to turn off the eyeball. I'm going to go and go to File, Open Recent, because I recently had Honeysuckle open. Took this in my back patio. And let's say I only wanted these leaves here. So I'll go into Magic Wand. I have it at Tolerance 32 and select those leaves. And there are other tools that are really good, but I'll do my selection. So it's not perfect, but if I want it to be perfect, all I have to do is go back into Quick Mask. Now I can't see it that well. If you want to invert a Quick Mask, Command or Control I on the PC. I don't even like that color. It's a little brown. Let me see, go back into here. See that? I'm going to make it a little redder. Not too red. Okay. Back into Quick Mask. Oh, not too much redder. I will get the brush. Now I have to make sure I have white. And I'm going to, oh no, white's taking away. Sorry, black. If it's ever not what you want, I'm going to use the bracket key to make, the left bracket key to make my brush smaller. Let's zoom in, because I'm making, it doesn't matter if I make mistakes. I'm going to zoom in. There we go, that's much better. Hand. Now I seem to be in the zoom tool, somehow mine keeps defaulting to minus. I like it in the plus. So I'm going to go back to the brush, and I'm going to just paint around the edges. I'm going to make my brush a little smaller. See, I went over here, so I want to get white so I can take away this extra because I just want those leaves. Now some black. I'm going to go in here, and paint, paint, paint. Get these leaves. And I'm not getting the flowers. They're so tiny, I decided not to get them. And this is pretty much, I just wanted to show you a real life example. I like to make a basic selection first, and I've gone too far. So I'm going back and forth between white and black, adding and taking away Quick Mask. See these little holes? If I cut this out now, it would have those tiny little holes in it. That wouldn't be fun. So there we go. I'm going to go out of Quick Mask. The keyboard shortcut is Q. So I can see some mistakes. See, I don't want that. So I'm going to, again, invert this. See? And I'm going to paint with black because I don't want that. I'm going to use my right bracket key and make the brush a little bigger. That's the shortcut. Left bracket key makes it smaller. I'm going to switch with my X key to white so I can get rid of that. And black, get rid of that. White, get rid of that. Get rid of that. Black. Oops, white. And basically you're hand drawing with quick mask. Your hand, but you can't do anything else in quick mask. Nothing. Oops. Undo. Switch over to white because I want to get rid of those little dots. And then I'm going to go out of quick mask. I'm going to double click the zoom tool. That's 100%. Double click the hand tool so it fits on screen. And that's what I've got selected. Now I see a little extra there. So I'm going to zoom back in for a second. See all that? This would probably be easier if I got the marquee tool. Hold the shift because I want to add that little piece to the selection. And I want to take away this. So I'm going to get my polygon tool. Hold my option key, alt if you're on a PC. And that's gone. And this would be add to because I don't want little holes in my selection. See the little plus? Again, add to, little plus. And now there's my selection. Oops, I see another one. So sometimes you can see them better in quick mask and sometimes you can see them better in marching ants. See, I see that little tiny bit there. I'm wondering if I zoom way in, if I can do that by hand. And yes, I can. See that and that? Want white, brush, get rid of that. Get rid of that, get rid of that. Make my brush a little smaller with the left bracket key. I see some more there. I see some more there. And oops, undo, X, I switched over to black. And then double click the hand tool, fit on screen. And now I have those leaves available, but I still have to make sure I go back to marching ants. Now I can do a copy paste. In one keystroke, I do Command J. It copies and pastes it in place. And that's what I've got. Now I've got a little more cleaning up to do. And this is when we would get into Refine Edge with the marching ants or with a layer mask. And we're not doing that in this lesson. There you go.